everyone, Jason Schapper here, MzeroA.com. Today, departing a Class Delta airport. And I want to take you through that process because radio communications, they're intimidating. Where do we start? Well, really, it starts with having our taxiway diagram out. I've got it on the iPad here. I've got it on the iPad here. Talk about redundancy, right? We have all these great systems here to assist us in that. And then from there, we want to grab the ATIS. What is the latest weather? Let's listen to that here together.
Zero, clear. Temperature 242.23, altimeter 3016. Visual approach in use, landing runway 36. VFR departure is advised ground control direction of flight. Advised on initial contact, give information Charlie.
Charlie.
Check out our information Charlie, 1251 Zulu. Wind calm, visibility 10, clear. Temperature 242.23, altimeter 3016. Visual approach in use, landing runway 36. VFR departure is advised ground control direction of flight. Advised on initial contact, give information Charlie.
Information Charlie is what we have here. I wrote that down, 10 in clear. Information Charlie, 3016, altimeter setting this in. I want to get everything ready ahead of time. And then at a Class Delta airport, I like to cold call. Now, not every airport always needs a cold call, but usually the busier ones do. And at a place like Ocala, sometimes the ground controller is also the tower controller running clearances on the phone with Jack's approach, whatever it may be. I like to personally give them a cold call. So let's go ahead, confirm I'm on ground, everything looks good. Let's give them a cold call to get their attention first. Good morning, Ocala Ground. Skyhawk 2-3, Mike Zulu.
Skyhawk 2-3, Mike Zulu, Ocala Ground. Go ahead, sir.
2-3, Mike Zulu's at the North T hangars with information Charlie, ready to taxi VFR to the west.
Cessna 2-3 Mike Zulu, Cal Ground, Roger, runway 36, taxiway Alpha.
36 via Alpha, thank you, 2-3 Mike Zulu. Notice too, I ended, let me write that down as well, I ended the radio call with us, 36 via Alpha. I ended the radio call with 2-3 Mike Zulu. A common mistake people make on the readback is they go, 2-3 Mike Zulu, 36 via Alpha. Well, understand this, you will never forget who you are. It's placarded right in front of you, right? You will never forget who you are, but you will forget what the controller just told you, right? 36 via Alpha, there's Alpha. 36 to the left, clear right, clear left. I'm heading to the left here, 36 via Alpha. Confirm that on my taxiway diagrams and my clearance, all is good. I have a nice long taxi down to Alpha here. You will never forget who you are, but you will forget what ATC just told you. 36 via Alpha, 2-3 Mike Zulu, is the proper way to read that back. Radio communications are like ordering pizza. Who are you? Where are you? And what do you want? 2-3 Mike Zulu, I'm at the North T hangars with information Charlie. I'm ready to taxi, and I'm VFR West. I'm closed traffic. I'm VFR North. And explain to them what you wish to do. You know, radio communications are so difficult. Why I have this long taxi here, I'll share with you a story. And some of you know this story. Well over a decade ago, when I was learning to fly, I just soloed. And those of you who know my story and the MzeroA story know that my solo was, or even before my solo, was quite an experience where I literally missed the runway. Long story. Almost gave up flying at that point. I had finally soloed, and I was doing my Ocala at the time was pilot controlled. So I had to go to the Gainesville airport to do my 3 tower takeoff and landings to a full stop. It's a private pilot at the time, PTS, now ACS requirement. And I went up there, and my radio communications were sloppy. I could fly the airplane, but my radio communications were so sloppy. And I went up there, and I landed, and they landed me on 2-4, and I was really nervous. Just, I'd never really talked. I'd done a few landings with my instructor there, but solo is just nerve-wracking, right? Maybe you can relate to this. I landed runway 2-4, and I pull off, and I explain I need a back taxi to 2-4, because they're full stops, right? So I'm coming back, and he tells me, you know, left on out, whatever the radio call was, back to 2-4. Well, instead of making a left to 2-4, I end up making a right-hand turn. And I'm just taxiing, and I'm taxiing away, and the ground controller comes on, and at the time it was 6711 Juliet. He goes, 11 Juliet, what are you doing? And, oh, well, sir, I'm on my solo cross-country, and I have to do this requirement for these 3 takeoff and landings. I have to, and I'm telling him why I'm at the Gainesville Airport. He goes, no, 11 Juliet, what are you doing? I thought, oh, I just explained to you, sir, but I'll tell you again. Yeah, so I have these, I got to do these three landings. They had to be a full stop. That's why I didn't do a touch and go this time. And I'm telling this man my life story. And finally he goes, no, 1-1 Juliet, stop. Where are you going? And I stopped in the middle of the taxi. He goes, runway 24 is back behind you. And literally, with my tail between my legs, made a 180-degree turn and taxied back to runway 24. And he was very, very friendly about it. However, it was funny that when I ended up coming back to the Ocala Airport, my instructor was ironically waiting for me right on the ramp, kind of with her arms folded, just watching. And she ends up going, so, Jason, how was it? Oh, it was great. I told you, it was a fantastic flight. And he goes, oh, okay. And I guarantee Gainesville Tower might have made a friendly phone call down here just to let him know that, hey, the guy flying 101 Juliet needs a little bit of work on his radio calls, which is a very, very accurate a statement, to say the least here. But anyways, I share that with you, and we teach through stories to let you know that you're not alone. Radio communications are very difficult. There's two types of pilots in flight training. There's those that are trained at a pilot-controlled airport and are amazing at pilot-controlled radio communications, but are terrified. Raised in the pilot-controlled environment and are amazing at pilot-controlled, uncontrolled radio communications, but terrified of towers. That was me. Then there's the other pilots who were raised in the towered environment and are awesome at towered radio communications, but are terrible or terrified, maybe, when it comes to pilot-controlled radio operations, and you have to get good at both. Anyways, we're taxiing up. We're at the end of our taxiway, and we have an interesting situation. We're about number 3 for departure here. There's a Cirrus, and looks like a Cherokee 140, ironically, right here in front of us. I have to do my engine run-up anyways, but we're going to kind of show some of that so you can see and listen to this process. Now, I'm coming up. I'm at the end of my taxi. I am going to go ahead and switch to tower now so I can start listening to see what's happening with this. So we're going
to
flip-flop over.
Start your turn to 270 and contact Jack's approach.
One on final. I'm just kind of seeing the lay of the land here. I'm going to listen while I knock out my run-up, and you can listen along, too.
Continue down when I call your base.
So I got one on final, one on downwind calling this base. It's a busy, busy day here. I'm going to knock out my run-up checklist here while we wait just a little bit. Right side up, left side down. Pull back, pull forward. Looks good. Everything looks set. Flight controls free and correct. Instruments confirmed set. Everything looks good here. Instruments set. Fuel selector valve confirmed both. Trim set for takeoff. Still just wait for this guy on final. One on downwind here. Picture's going right, so I was going 17. With the new EI engine monitoring, easy to get really picky. Well, G1000's a similar way, right? You want to get right to 1700. Well, you get close. There we go, 1710. Not going to get too picky. Mac check. Left mag, good. Back to both. Right mag. Nice drops. Then tolerances. Back to both. Carburetor heat check. Great drop.
Just 1 Victor Kilo, continue downwind, number 2 following the traffic ahead of you.
Listen,
southwest
number
extent.
2, so I'm going to be here for a bit, it sounds like. Idle smooth. And run up is complete. I am going to be sitting here for a bit. So we're going to go ahead, we're going to pause this video, we're going to skip ahead till I'm pretty sure I'm number 1 or at least number 2 for this runway.
Cherokee 7182 Juliet, runway 36, cleared for takeoff, and west departure is approved. Cessna departing ahead of you is in left traffic.
Cherokee 7182 Whiskey, cleared for departure, runway 36.
Whiskey, roger. There's a Cessna traffic on about a half mile final, no delay.
No delay, got traffic, 8-2 Whiskey.
All right, 8-2 Whiskey, leaving in front of
Cherokee
me.
Departing ahead of
I've got one on final, he's departing. I know he's going to tell me to hold short, but I'm going to let him know that I'm here. And Ocala Tower 23 Mike Zulu, Alpha 1136, holding short.
Cessna 23 Mike Zulu, Ocala Tower, hold short of runway 36, landing traffic.
Holding short 36, 23 Mike Zulu. And I told him that. I just want to let him know I'm number 1 in sequence.
Stop
and I'm ready.
444 for
I'm glad we paused the video for a bit. I was sitting there for a good 6-7 minutes of just inbound and outbound traffic. So we're going to wait just a bit longer. I've got one landing. He just departed. I think he's going to get me out after this aircraft. So I'm going to double check that everything is set, because I was sit for quite a bit. Everything is good. I just need to close my Florida air conditioning. Everyone always asks, well, Jason, why are you taxiing with the door open? Well, if you flew in Florida...
Okay, Whiskey, do you have the Cessna head turning crosswind?
He's inside A2 Whiskey.
Roger, pass behind that traffic.
All right, I'll pass behind him, A2 Whiskey.
We're just waiting. Watching, he's on the ground. It looks like he's taxiing off. Oh, no, he might be doing a stop and go. Yeah, he's bringing his flaps up in the middle of the runway, so he's probably doing a stop and go. A very long stop and go. And he might get me out before this next plane comes here. There, he's rolling now. I'm going to inch up just a hair so I'm ready and I can help him with the sequencing just a bit. And I'm waiting for that radio call. There's my hold short line. Don't want to get too close to it.
Cessna 23 Mike Zulu, runway 36 cleared for takeoff. West departure approved. The Cessna departing ahead of you is in left close traffic.
36 clear for takeoff. Westbound approved. We'll keep an eye on that traffic. Thank you. 23 Mike Zulu. All right, so I told him we're 36. Really, all that needed to be read back there that was pertinent information.
Frequency change approved.
It was 36, clear for takeoff, left turn approved.
Frequency change approved.
The traffic information was just helpful for me. It didn't need to be read back. Using every bit of runway.
72 Whiskey, runway 36, cleared for touch and go. The wind is variable at 4.
Heels hit the floor, toes the bottom pedal, smoothly applying some full power. Confirm. Engine gauge is all green. Engine gauge is all green. Airspeed's alive, airspeed's alive. Rolling. About 1,000 feet of runway gone. There's 60, we're flying. A class delta departure. That was a little, not complex, but just, that was a lengthy process, a very long taxi, a very busy day, and what you need to understand is no two radio communications are the same. ATC can throw a kink in it, and you have to be ready. The best tip I can give you, though, is remember, you'll never forget who you are, but you will forget what ATC told you. On a readback, say what they just told you, the pertinent information, then end with your tail number. And that's on the readbacks, not on the initial calls. That's on the readbacks here. Hey, listen. We've been giving away a Bose headset every single month so far. November 29th is our next live stream. I'm doing a great mock check ride. I'm going to ask actual FAA check ride questions, and then I'm going to go ahead and provide you with the best answers. I'll read your answers in the chat, and we're going to work to formulate the best answers for private instrument and commercial check rides. I'll be asking those questions live on Facebook and on YouTube. That's November 29th at 8 p.m. Eastern Time. Then at the end, well, I'm giving away another Bose headset. There's already an event up on Facebook, so you can check all that out, and I will see you all on November 29th. Can't wait to read your comments below this video on Facebook, on YouTube, on MzeroA.com. Enjoy the rest of your day, and most importantly, remember that a good pilot is always learning how to fake. Guys, we'll see you.